My name is Phillip Aubrey. My company is Yunit, and this is my innovation challenge pitch.
Hello, everyone. My name is Phillip Aubrey, and I'm the founder and CEO of Yunit, a mobile app that makes saving together safe and easy. The problem we're here to address today is that 73% of millennials have less than $400 in savings. This translates to us being the brokest generation this country has ever seen. And the reasons are clear. We have lower financial literacy rates. We've been saddled with debts, but above all else, legacy financial products are no longer working for us. So that's why we created Yunit, a mobile app that makes saving together safe and easy. The easiest way to think about Yunit is a shared savings account with some extra bells and whistles. No one else can ever touch your money, peer voting, group analytics. And we do all of this to really reinforce a transparency and accountability amongst groups. And naturally, when people think of Yunit, they think we're aiming to be another digital bank. And we are not. In fact, we partner with digital banks. Our long-term goal is to be able to become a collaborative investment platform where people save together, where people come together, save together, and invest together. The dream is to be a consumer version of AngelList. And to get here, we've done quite a bit. We created Yunit back in January 2020. We did raise our pre-seed round, and above all else, we have built a wait list that is over 30,000 people waiting to try the product out. And then in March of 2021, we launched our first iOS app. But what gets me most excited are the numbers. Right now, what we are seeing is that the average account holder has a balance of $1,120. This is three times higher than our peer set. Less than 1% of our users take money out. And above all else, this average account balance is only trending higher. We're able to see that the average user has a goal ranging between $4,000 and $5,000. So over time, this $1,100 figure will only creep closer. And to give you a better understanding of how Yunit operates in this competitive landscape, I have pulled out a few of our top competitors, Digit, Acorns, Capital, and Twine. And as you can see, our average account balance is nearly three to four times higher than every single person on this list. In addition to that, our app is completely free and we will never charge our users a dollar. And distribution is what gets me most excited. So every investor in this sort of space understands that distribution and CAC are the two most difficult things for consumer fintech products to crack. And we've done that. So for every one user we find, on average, they bring five people to the product during onboarding. This translates to low CAC, organic growth, high impact dollars that are not being spent on Facebook ads, but above all else, viral distribution. We monetize through a referral model. On average, we're able to make between $2,700 and $6,800 per group. This comes from a combination of mortgage lenders, credit card referrals, and then relevant community stakeholders. We spend most of our time focusing on minorities and migrants, not only because are they the most underserved in this space, but above all else, this sort of collaborative savings process is ingrained in our cultures. Around the world, this collaborative savings process has a lot of different names. In Nigeria, this would be considered a susu. In Thailand, a tata. And in Latin America, la lotería, which translates to the lottery. And just briefly, a bit about me. I've been working on startups since I was 13. This is my third company. I started my career in private equity, moved into venture capital, and decided to leave the venture capital world because we believe that we need tools that work for us, not against us. We believe that everyone should have access to opportunities, not just the rich. And above all else, we believe that the only way for us to make lasting change is for us to do it together. And that's why we created Yunit. Thank you.